So here's another trick. Maybe we didn't get the power half right away. Maybe we broke them down doing something else. But we get an E-drape bend or a parallel rod, and we break them down, okay? Right there. But we don't necessarily get the power half, right? So look at the power half real quick. Here's the trick to get it. Or maybe they got their elbows back, right, and their wrists are in like this right here. Heads up, because you know the power half's coming. So bottom guy, you're good at wrestling too. You're kind of powering up and keeping it. Well, yeah, there you go. He's got hip pressure and your hips are down, but usually they're all like powered up, their neck's strong, right, and they're hard to turn. These are the guys we really want to turn, are the guys that are strong and good at wrestling. So they're in there like that, okay? Here's the general rule. We'll go over some crossface stuff later, but the general rule is crossface, power half. Crossface, power half. Does everybody understand that? These arms are out, it's like looking for a crossface cradle, right? Okay? The arms are in. Then here's our first little trick, okay? I like to go double so they don't know which way I'm going. But I'm going to reach under and grab his wrist with both hands right there. Now, when you take somebody, come here somebody, okay? If he's on bottom and I grab his wrist and start pulling back, what does he do to defend that? What's one way to defend that a lot of people do? Swim it out.
Awesome.
Anybody ever heard that? Swim out. If they get a one-on-one, swim it out. Right. So many people do that that we know they're going to do it. That's good stuff. Okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to start pulling those wrists underneath. And what we want here, and we're going to go in slow motion, is this bottom guy is going to swim that out right here. And for a split second, that arm is right here. Do you guys see that? Now we could just crush it, break it, and be the ultimate gladiator. We're not there yet. That's a couple years. Instead, what we're going to do is we take this arm. We're going to hook at the elbow right when it gets there. We take our forearm, drive it into the back of his neck as hard as the ref will let us. We're going to lift. Just lift. Just lift first so he can't get it where he wants it. Do you guys understand that? Once you got it in the air, block. Right? Now, where does the elbow go? Don't lift it in the air. Elbow to the air. Right? There you go. Fist on the mat. Pop off. There you go. There you go. Lift that head, right? Sink it a little bit deeper. Lift that head. Awesome. Other guy on top. That's a little trick to force that power half. He knows it's coming. We're going to make it happen anyways. All right, so we go parallel our knee drape. We break him down. But he's got his elbows tight, his head up. You're not stalling. Your head's up. Like, if they're stalling, you just rub their face in the mat. So give me this right here. Kind of more like chest up, too. There we go. They're about to power up, right? We want them to come up. So what we're going to do is we're going to go underneath and grab their wrists. When we pull it back, they're going to swim it. That we're going to catch it when they swim it and lift it up in the air. No. See if you put your fist down and did this. Instead, catch it so you can't. There you go. Now lock. Nope. Yeah, there you go. Now put the elbow in the air. There you go. Fist on the mat. Hop off. Shoulder deep. Nice. Power step. Nice. Okay? I want you to roll those one-on-ones. When he swims it out, catch it. Lock it. Catch it. Don't try and just lock it. They're gonna bring that arm out. Okay? So when they go to roll it out, catch it, lock it. Everybody got it? All right, one, two, three.